In 2012, the Public Service Commission recruited 235 staff for Kampala Capital City Authority. However, KCCA declined to deploy them, yet they were given appointment letters. MPs accused KCCA top officials for deliberately sitting on appointments of these staff to favor their relatives who were serving on positions on short contracts.
The same people who were appointed by KCC and you stood on their way kept their appointment letters, you and MCC by then. And we cried to you, and the same tears you are crying to the ED that they have not allowed you to access their office. We told you, these are legitimate people appointed by government, by public service. And you are lying that the public service agreed on that stampede.
Who hinted on it? That people had in-laws, brothers, sisters, nephews. Then those nephews and in-laws and what failed to make it on the interview.
11 of the aggrieved persons dragged KCCA to court, and the matter was settled in consent judgment, where KCCA agreed to compensate them with 3.5 billion shillings, which amount was aggregated from the sum of wages they would have received if the appointment succeeded.
Paying them money they should have earned per month for all this time, and yet they did not work for a single day. Do you think this was proper in your view?
It was going to result into paying more money from the institution because there was already precedence for Doron Kusima.
However, Kosase discovered that the former director, Legal Affairs, Charles Ouma, committed KCCA in the compensation of 3.5 billion shillings in the consent judgment without approval of the top management.
Yes, consent judgments are good because, you know, as long as the process is handled properly, you save billions of shillings. But the point of contention was whether management was involved and that it gave its approval. You also mentioned that management was not aware of this 3.7 billion consent agreement judgment and did not give a nod.
Indeed, and that's what Engineer Chitaka intimated at the time, because we requested for those minutes and they actually informed us that those minutes couldn't be traced. And I actually was on record before this committee saying we had instructions as the Directorate of Legal Affairs to challenge these consents because the minutes couldn't be traced, so we're not in a position to actually say that management approved these settlements.
Ouma labored to explain his actions. He noted that before the 11 aggrieved persons went to court, there was already a precedent over one Doreen Tusimi, who sued KCCA and court ordered the authority to pay her over 100 million shillings in compensation.
The institution has been served billions, tens of billions of shillings because of the advert. Because this was again advice we rendered following meetings with Public Service Commission and Minister of Public Service, advertise that whoever is still interested in these jobs, please come forth. For those who do not show up between the period that has been granted by the institution, we do not owe them a responsibility to take them on. Indeed, some people joined, some did not join.
Kosase directed KCCA to take action against the two former directors who committed the entity without authority of top management. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.